Hello guys, welcome to SWK Tutorials. Today tutorial is how to create water puddle on road using Vray for 3ds Max. After watching this tutorial, you can easily create water puddle on road plus other materials like mud on sand, rust on object, etc. etc. It's slightly tricky, but I will teach you water puddle in just 7 simple steps. So without any further ado, let's get started. Step 1. Create water puddle texture map in Photoshop. Now make the water puddle shape. And fill it with white. Give it a Gaussian blur of 2 pixels and save it as water puddle texture map. Step 2. Create wet road texture map. Go to image, make a duplicate of it. Take your brush. This wet road texture map should be greater than your water puddle. And give it a Gaussian blur of 2 pixel 2. Now this was my original water puddle and you can see I have increased it in my wet road texture map. This is the water puddle map that I will be using in the future and this is my wet road texture map. Step 3. Apply water puddle texture map and adjust it. I am assuming that you guys know UVW mapping, else you will find it a little bit difficult to follow. And believe me, this is the most difficult part in this whole tutorial, else everything is extremely easy. So open the material editor, select the road mesh and assign it a material. In your diffuse slot, apply a checker. And click on Show Shaded Map in Viewport. Next, you can use Unwrap UVW or UVW Map. It's up to you. I will be using UVW Map. Now, click on Gizmo, click on W and just make it a little bit small. In my top viewport, I have to make sure that this black and white checkers are perfect square. They should not be rectangles. So I will scale it like this and something like this. Now this road will not give any stretching because these checkers are perfect squares. So the next step is again go to your material editor, select the road and assign it another material. In its diffuse, select a bitmap and assign it wet road texture map. Now it can be a little bit tricky, but it's not that much difficult. Just again assign it and click it Show Shaded Map in Viewport. The thing that you have to do is that you have to again click on the gizmo and move your gizmo like this. Now you can decrease the size of your water puddle if you want it, but make sure you do not scale it in one axis. Just scale it in two axis like this. And I want my water puddle to be somewhere like this. Okay guys, I'm about to tell you something extremely important. So listen it very carefully. If you are using UVW map modifier, you can see there are many textures here. The texture is repeating itself, but the most important one is this one that is between these four lines. make sure that you are seeing the texture you are seeing in your camera, render camera, is the one that is inside these lines. It should not be like this. If it is like this, if you are seeing this one, then you will face problem in the future. So make sure the texture you are seeing in your camera is the one that is between the lines. Step 4. Create a Vray road material. Open material editor. Assign it a new material. Name it road. In the diffuse slot, I am using this bitmap from textures.com. I will put its link in the description. And in the bump map, I will be using this height texture. Now render the scene. The road texture is okay. Step 5. Create a wet road material. This is extremely simple. Just copy the road material and make its texture dark. You can either do it in Photoshop, or if you are a lazy person like me, you can do it like this. Into your diffuse texture, click here. And then in your output parameters, check enable color map. Double click here to see what is about to happen. Now, decrease it like this. You can see that it's becoming dark. The best thing is that place it 0.5. So I have decreased it like this. This is my road texture, that is normal texture, and this is my wet road texture that will be little bit dark. Now go to parents and rename it to wet road. Step 6. Create a water material. Click here. Click on the diffuse. Change it to black. Reflection. Take it nearly full. And change your glossiness to 0.96. But no refraction. Yes, no refraction. I know. In real life, water has refraction transparency. But still, we will not turn on refraction here, else we will get unrealistic results. Now, to apply the road, wet road, and water material on the road mesh, you need a Vray material that can be used to layer several Vray materials on top of each other. So, step 7. Create a Vray blend material and apply it to the road mesh. So click here and double click on Vray blend material. Discard the old material and click OK. Now assign it to the road material. A Vray blend material simply combines multiple material in different ways on top of each other. They are very similar to Photoshop layers. Base layer is at the bottom. Coat material one layer is on top of base material, this one, and coat material two is on top of coat material one, and so on. So drag the road material on base material, wet road material on coat material 1, water on coat material 2. Now, if we render, we will see water on the whole road because it is the top layer. But we want water puddle on the road. So, we will put water puddle texture map we have created in step 1 into blend amount texture slot. Blend amount is simply the opacity of the coat material. Black means the coat material invisible, while white make it visible. Since we want to control the water with the texture, therefore we will make the blend amount color black and put the texture here we have created in step 1. Water puddle texture map. Render the scene. Now we will fix two things. Remove the water repetition you are seeing here and here, and add some transparency in water. To remove repetition, go to your water puddle texture map you have just placed and uncheck U and V tiles. Click on go to parent, and to add some transparency in water, change the blend amount to 85. This will make sure that water coat material is 85% visible at this area and 15% transparent, which means that 85% water coat material will be shown and 15% the materials below it, that is wet road. Render again. Now compare both the results. You can see in the previous result the water repetition was on, and in the new result there is no water repetition. Plus there is no transparency in this water here, but if I right now go here, you can see a little bit of transparency. Let me just zoom it. Just try to look here carefully. This part. You can see a little bit of what a road texture underneath it. No road texture, road texture. Next, we will control wet road coat material 1 with the texture. So, change it to black. Click here and this time use wet road texture map we have created in step. Again, uncheck the tile option and render. Here is our final render, that is water puddle on the wet road. You can see the structure is extremely simple. That's my road. On my road, I have my wet road, which is controlled by a texture, and after that my water, that is again controlled by the texture. And remember, you can decrease the texture opacity with this value. So guys, I hope you like this tutorial. If you like it, give it a like. If you love it, subscribe to my channel, share my videos. Keep creating guys. Bye bye.